this, as you can see, is yet another scene of Gandalf and the Balrog. I'd ordered this after the film experience, and so I decided to steer clear of the film design, which means quite a few changes have crept in. I planned on a flaming mane for Bill. That's his name, you know. He always gets called the Balrog, poor chap. He had a name, no one ever stopped asking though. Terrible. Anyhow, the flaming mane. I quite like the idea, but the publisher stopped me on the grounds that a flaming mane may tempt children to play with matches, which is quite dangerous. Gandalf has lost his pointy hat too, which was deliberate on my part, as at the time I was tired of drawing them. I'd just completed the infamous illustration Gandalf's Wardrobe and the 1001 Pointy Hats. A lot has been written about Balrogs and whether or not they have wings. The answer is quite easy. Just ask Bill.
Neon does ask me though, do they? I'm just expected to run around half the time with these great wings of mine. To the times I've got no wings at all. I don't know whether I'm coming again some days. Anyways, these wings in particular, I got them from Mordor Mail Order Supplies. You can get to them on interweb like. Anyways, I've got to fight this little wizard bloke for a minute. We all know that turns out. Typical, eh?
Right, thanks for that, Bill. Very informative. I'd like to take a moment to clarify something. People have commented that I don't have a Canadian accent. Well, I don't know what they're talking about, eh? Everyone from British Columbia speaks like this. Just ask my good friend Brian Adams. He's from round that way, you know. Anywho, until next time, keep your pencil sharp and keep scribbling.